Are stainless propellers worth it? What's up with pitch diameter, rake, and cupping? I'm gonna go over all this and more in today's video about stainless steel propellers. What's up, guys? For today's video, I'm gonna be going over stainless steel propellers, a lot of facts about how propellers work, some of the benefits that you can only get with stainless steel, and if they're worth it for your outboard. Now, there's a lot of things to consider when it comes to stainless steel propellers. For one, aluminum propellers, while they might not be as durable, they certainly take a beating and they don't damage your engine if you happen to hit something. However, if you're in an area with a lot of sand and a lot of things that might chew up the aluminum blades, you might be going through an aluminum prop every year, depending on your conditions. If durability isn't on your mind and you're really just looking for best performance out of your outboard, whether it be a 20 horse or 150 horse, a stainless steel propeller might be for you. For today, I'm going to be installing this PowerTech SRA3 propeller on my 25 horsepower Yamaha. The stock propeller that comes with the engine is an 11 and a quarter pitch. I went with an 11 pitch PowerTech to get started. I wanted to stay pretty close to what I had originally because my RPMs were already up there at a really high mounting level on the engine. So to get started, let's go ahead and take this out and see how a stainless steel propeller compares to an aluminum one. Now, if you can see right off the back, you might notice some differences with the stainless steel propeller. For one, it has this ridge on each blade. Not all stainless steel propellers have this, but it's not something you commonly see with aluminum propellers. And this is called a cup of your blade. When cupping is added to your propeller, it adds this lip, which allows your propeller, when it's turning through the water, to actually grab more water and pull it down, allowing you to run a little more shallow without blowing out your prop. That's one of the things I'm most excited to try with the stainless steel propeller, because where I have my engine mounted right now, it runs really, really well. I'm getting some pretty decent RPMs and speed, but if I try to trim up too high or sometimes on turns, I'll get a little too high in the water and it'll start to cavitate. It's just slightly, so I'm hoping that the cupping might alleviate that problem altogether. Now, something else that you might notice looking at the stainless steel propeller is how the blades look like they're kind of bent backwards. If we compare that against the aluminum prop, you can see how the blades are a little bit more upright. That tilting of the blades is called the rake of the propeller. In addition to the cupping, rake also helps a lot with running a little bit more shallow or where there are instances that your prop might make contact with the surface of the water. This angle to the blade will again help pull more water down onto the prop, or if you trim out real high on a jack plate, this is gonna allow you to keep more water on the propeller and not lose performance. Now, speaking of performance, one really important thing that stainless steel propellers can do for you is that they don't flex nearly as much in the water as aluminum propellers do. When you're under high load on the water and your engine is running at max horsepower, your blades are actually not as stiff as they seem. In the water, they can actually wobble back and forth, which all leads to degraded performance. Stainless steel, while a lot more rigid, does not have that problem. Now, the last thing I wanted to get over before we get into installation and testing on the water is the downsides to a stainless steel prop. And in my opinion, there's only about two. The first downside is the price. A stainless propeller is going to run roughly 2 to 3 times more than an aluminum propeller. You can justify that by the increased performance or the durability. So if you are running in conditions that chew up aluminum props, this will last a lot longer. The downside number two is that while the stainless steel prop is a lot more durable, if you're in a location where prop strikes are a possibility, a stainless steel prop might not be the best option for you, because with an aluminum prop, if you take a really hard hit and your propeller hits a tree stump or a rock or something like that, you might break a blade off, the aluminum prop might bend, or the hub inside might spin. But what that's doing is it's transferring the energy of the strike to the propeller and not to your lower unit. Because of the durability of the stainless steel propellers, if they hit something, a greater amount of that force is being transferred right to your lower unit and prop shaft, which could lead to engine damage if you hit something really bad. So it's definitely worth considering where you're going to be running your boat and if a stainless steel propeller is for you. Okay, so to get started, first thing I'm going to do is pull this aluminum prop off, put the stainless steel one on, and then we're going to get out in the water and see if it makes a difference. Now, I won't bore you guys with a lengthy installation video. If you guys want more information on how to install a prop, I have videos dedicated just to that. But the basics are you're going to need to remove the cotter pin. This one's already been removed. You're going to have to take off the prop nut. When you're removing the bolt, you have to brace your blade in some way. The easiest way is to use a block of wood. You can put the block of wood between your propeller and the cavitation plate. That way, when you turn, you don't have to worry about the blade spinning. And just before I put the new one on, you guys can see a really good comparison. Now this is a 10 diameter stainless and a 9 3/4 diameter aluminum. So the stainless is gonna be a little bit wider. They do have roughly the same pitch, so the spacing between the blades is about the same. This is gonna have a little bit more rake, so you can kinda see how the stainless blades are turned back a little bit. And then of course, the stainless has the cupping, which is a ridge along this top edge here of the stainless prop, and the aluminum blade does not have that. All right, with this installed, I'm planning on going out tomorrow to test it, so I'll check back with you guys on the water. All right, well, now that we're back out on the water, we got the new prop on the motor. Looks like we're idling around 900 RPM, which is pretty good. A little bit less than the previous prop, but that would make sense considering it's a larger prop with a larger diameter. Let's go ahead and open it up and see what this thing can do. Now, just as a comparison, my max speed at this current engine height was about 25, 26 miles per hour. So I'm curious to see if I'll hit that or do even better. And also the RPMs around that speed was around 56 to 5700. So I'm hoping, I mean, ideally I want 58 to 6000 RPMs and a top speed of better than 27. But I don't think I'm gonna get that with this prop. But you know what? We'll see. So let's give it a go. Something else I did before I went out last time is I braced the side console here, and it feels much more sturdy. So I'm curious to see how the shake is gonna be. Let's crank it up some. So while the prop had the same top speed, my RPMs dropped about 500, I'd say, close to that, which means that it's definitely overpropped as a stainless prop for this engine in this motor setup. I also went up in diameter, so you know that all kind of makes sense. When you go up in diameter, you're gonna lose some RPMs. When you go up in pitch, you're gonna lose some RPMs. When you go to stainless, you're gonna lose some RPMs because it's that much more stiff. This was some good testing today. I think what I'm gonna do is exchange the prop for either a 10 pitch, possibly even a 9 pitch, and we'll see how that performs. I'm gonna reach out to my prop guy, see what we can do about an exchange, hopefully go down a pitch or two. I'm also considering lowering the engine height again. Right now I have it in the middle mounting hole. I might need to go down one more. I got two more holes I can try. Right now the cavitation plate is dead even with the bottom of the boat. That's technically where you're supposed to have it, but I do have pods on the boat which tend to just keep the boat higher out of the water in general. So I think going down a little bit under the boat is going to help me here, because what happens is as soon as I start to apply any kind of power to the engine, it just starts sucking air. I hope I got some good recordings of it because I want to see it myself, but it's hard to see while you're actually driving. So if I did, I'll throw them up on the screen now. As you can hopefully see, as soon as I start to apply power, the prop just sucks the water in, then it just starts sucking air, and that's at a neutral trim position. In order to run it as it currently is, I have to keep the motor tucked in real close to the transom, and I don't think that's the best way to do it. And then also, when I start to trim out at planing speed, I either start porpoising real bad or I start sucking in air. So I'm gonna see what I can do about getting a smaller prop and going down in engine height and seeing how that all performs.